This project has a master plan, but we will only be focusing on this large area. We will start off much like we did when generating the mass grading, with two zones. These are represented here as the green polylines that encompass the area we want to work with. Again, these are just closed polylines that we will use for the zones. The outside line we will set for our grading limit, and the inside line we will control how we want things to slope across the parking surface. We need to apply the zone grading objects to our polylines. You can access the grading objects through the ribbon, but you can also access the grading objects by selecting Control 3 on your keyboard to access them. Now that the polylines represent zones, we need to do a bit of setup. We will start by selecting the outer zone. For the min slope, we will use 0%, and for the max slope, we will use 50%. This zone will also represent our grading limit, so we will toggle that on. For the second zone, we will toggle on slopes, and then set the min slope to 2%, and set the max slope to 5%. This will meet the parameters for my parking area. Next grading object that we will define is the building pad. The only thing that we will be sure is toggled on is level grading with pad. You do have the option to set an elevation, but I want the solver to figure that for me. I want to be able to control the slope on the sidewalk to be sure that ADA requirements are met. I will define the sidewalks using the accessible path grading object. Once defined, I can edit the name of the zone properties so that I can better understand just what is what when I get into the solver. I will set the min slope to 0% and the max slope to 2%. I will duplicate this for the sidewalk selected. I have some parking spaces up close to the front of the building that I know are going to have to meet ADA requirements also. So I will create zones for these areas and set the constraints accordingly. I also want there to be a flatter surface in front of the building, so I have added a zone to reflect just that. All of these zones will have a min slope of 0.5% and a max slope of 2%. I show some inlets in the parking area, depicting where I want to drain the parking area. We will use drain lines to make this happen. I will draw a polyline for each drain line that I want to define. Remember that drain lines are drawn from top to bottom, or high point to low point. If this is reversed, the drainage will not flow in the direction that you want. With the drain lines in place, I now need to define the polylines as a drain line grading object. The drain lines will have to be selected one at a time to define them. Once defined, you can select a drain line and see that grading optimization will create a break line along each of the drain lines you have defined, directing the water to a low point. I would like to add my curb islands also that are shown in my parking area. We can use the curb grading object to define them. Much like roadway subassemblies in Civil 3D, you can look at any of the grading object properties and change them so that what you change becomes default. This is what I want to do before I start selecting all of the islands. Last item I would like to define is the truck well at the southeast corner of the building. In this particular instance, we will need to create two zones to represent the wall of the truck well. Then, using the polyline edit command, I will close both of the polylines shown. You need to be sure that both polylines touch or overlap the building edge. I will be sure to snap them to the edge of the building. For the inside polyline, the edge of the polyline needs to sit directly on top of the outside polyline at the beginning of the truck well. Now we will define both polylines with a zone grading object. For the outside zone, we will toggle on relax slopes, so we will not be setting actual percentages to this zone. We also will toggle on override objectives because we want it to override what is going on in this specific area. For the inside zone, we will also toggle relax slopes. We also will toggle on align surface so that it will align with the surface at the beginning of the truck well and the building pad when we add the reveal on the building pad next. We need to place a reveal on the inside of the truck well along the building so that grading optimization knows that the truck well is sloping down towards the building. Be sure when you create the reveal that you snap to the inside of the truck well when defining. We have given it the limits. Now we will set the minimum difference and maximum difference to 4 feet. With all of our grading objects set, now we are ready to run the optimization.